Welcome to the Rainmaker Podcast, where we help business-minded real estate agents stop chasing leads and help them start attracting business. We don't claim to make winners here. We do claim that we help winners win bigger and faster. Building your business is building your database, one that works harder for you than you do for it. So if you want to get off the transaction treadmill, keep on listening. If you want the shortcut to dominating your market, then go to www.marketmakersystems.com/demo. Welcome to the Rainmaker Podcast, where we help business-minded real estate agents stop chasing leads and help them start attracting business. We don't claim to make winners here. We do claim that we help winners win bigger and faster. Building your business is building your database, one that works harder for you than you do for it. So if you want to get off the transaction treadmill, keep on listening. If you want the shortcut to dominating your market, then go to www.marketmakersystems.com/demo.
What's up, everybody? Mike Otto here. Hey, today I want to talk to you about, really, it's a success principle, a wealth principle. It's one that is very, very rarely understood. Easy to ignore, and you know, just something that most people neglect. I first learned about this from Dan Kennedy in this particular positioning, and I thought it was very interesting that he had brought it up. Now, if you don't know about Dan Kennedy, he is a marketing guru. He's kind of the godfather of direct response marketing. Cool guy to check out and study. I would definitely recommend that. You know, he's done big marketing campaigns and kind of birthed like every, you know, info guru that's out there. And so anyway, I'm studying him for a long time, have been for a long time. And one of, I don't remember, it was a tape or a newsletter or something he was talking about. No, it was definitely a lecture of some sort, because I remember hearing his voice, this success principle. And what he said was that wealthy people take a portion of their income and donate it. And he said, I don't know why this works. I don't know how it works. I just know that it works. And generally, the amount is 10%. And he said, you know, if you want to look for the clues and emulate the steps that people who have wealth take, this is one of them. And, you know, for me, growing up in church, I was like, isn't that interesting? It's a universal principle for me that was biblically based. And so, you know, as a young man going to church, looking at the pastor, I remember one time I was looking at the pastor. He had like this big gold cross on. You know, I was in a Lutheran church, and great pastor, great church. But I was young. I didn't know anything. And, you know, they're taking the tithe. And I'm like, well, why don't you throw in that necklace, bro? Like, you know, this is literally where my mind was at. And I was like, I don't feel like I'm going to tithe, you know. And I have a lot of apprehension about donating to charities. And, you know, what Dan said was it nothing to do with church, nothing to do with religion. He was just saying to donate. And, you know, for me, being on different boards, being a part of different organizations, I see a lot of fiscal mismanagement. And oftentimes, you know, things like Goodwill, for example, you know, you think that you're doing something good, but then you look at the salary of the CEO of Goodwill and you realize that, yeah, it's a nonprofit, but it's not without profit. Like, I forget how much that guy makes. And so oftentimes I'm apprehensive about giving to organizations because of that. And same with churches. You know, I go to a big old mega church down here. It's like the biggest church in the state of Missouri. And, you know, I'm like, do they even really need my money? I mean, they got so much. They got, you know, five buildings. They do this like tele-church thing. Like, you know what I mean? It looks like they've teleported there. Anyway, you know, and so I have trouble with that. I have trouble. Sometimes I struggle with it. But I can tell you for sure, without a doubt, that when I do give, and when I do give consistently, not only does my income go up, but what I'm able to keep ends up being more. So I don't know why it works. I don't know how it works. Like I said, it's a universal principle. No matter what side of the you know, argument you're on, religious or charitable, but it's definitely something that I have been aware of and I've strived to do. But again, it's easy to forget, you know, especially if you're like me and you're trying to do it through a church. You know, I go to church sometimes, I don't sometimes, and so it's hard to keep consistent with it. But I'm going to make a better effort, and I thought I would just share this with you all because it does have an impact, and it is a you know, very noticeable one. It's not like, you know, overnight, but over the duration of time, a month, a quarter, half a year, you know, I mean, last year during COVID, our business was shut down, right? It was just shut down And it was really rough. We had customers all over the country, you know, a lot of them in California. They're like, Mike, we're shutting off our home internet. You know what I mean? Like, we don't know when we're going to be able to eat again. We can't even go outside, right? We got a pause mark. We can't pay you. And I was just like, you know, my heart goes out to him. I'm like, all right, cool. Yep. I get it. Whatever you got to do. Then at the same time, I got all these employees, right? Luckily, I keep a ridiculous amount of core capital and we were good. I'm sharing all that with you to tell you this. One of the things that I knew for sure was that they were shutting down these churches. And so I stepped up, I made an effort to make sure that I donated, right, which in the church is called tithing, more than I ever had. And our top line revenue grew by a third last year in spite of COVID, in spite of the shutdowns. Now, I wasn't very impressed with this. I was sitting across from my banker and he's like, well, how's business this year? And I was like, oh, it's pretty good. You know, we grew by a third. And he like dropped his pen. He's like, what? I said, yeah, we only grew by a third. He's like, that's unbelievable. He said, all the businesses I'm talking to are down, right? He's like, nobody's growing. And I talked to an investment banker who I've been in touch with for years. Same thing, right? He's like, well, how's things going? I'm like, yeah, we are all right. We grew by a third. He's like, oh my God. He said, we're patching up businesses for equity capital and we're having to like reverse out the equation of how much that they lost due to COVID in order to just maintain valuations. He said, the fact that you grew is crazy. And, you know, it's kind of like the frog in the boiling pot thing. Like, you don't even really notice it, right? But in retrospect, looking back, I'm like, man, that had a significant impact. What was it? What was it? And I'm like, you know what? I did step up, and I did give more than I ever gave before, just because we couldn't go to church, right? And churches do a lot of good if they're the right church. You know, our church has a lot of community outreach. I mean, they paint the schools. They do all kinds of stuff, right? They feed the hungry. I mean, it's a cool thing. Now, I'm not saying you got to donate to church to make this happen. You can donate to any type of charity. My point is be consistent. Pick something. Make it a percentage of your income and do some good in the world. You know, personally, one of my favorites is St. Jude's. St. Jude's is a fantastic organization. I had an employee. His daughter got cancer. You know, it was really looking grim. They put them up, right? Like they paid for their travel. They paid for their stay. They paid for everything. They paid for all the medical treatment. They wiped this cancer out of this little girl, miraculously healed her. I mean, just phenomenal. Pretty awesome stuff, right? And so I feel good about giving to St. Jude. But do your research. Find some places where you can give back. Personally, I think locally is a place to start, you know, if you can find some local organizations, food banks, things of that nature. Good stuff. Anyway, that's what I got for you today. Hope you found value in it. Hopefully I kind of changed your paradigm there a little bit. And, you know, as always, we're here to help you if you need any help. Thanks so much. Make it a great day.
If you want us to generate, nurture, and deliver appointments directly to your calendar, I want you to go to marketmakercall.com right now and check if your area is available. If you want us to generate, nurture, and deliver appointments directly to your calendar, I want you to go to marketmakercall.com right now and check if your area is available.